It was a long day out on that sea, and the storm blew in with a quickness. The sky turned ominous, and lightning lit it up. The sound of thunder rattled your bones. One of my sailors declared that it was Hecate and her minions sending the storm in recompense for something his wife said. When his wife told him the story originally, he had thought her mad. However, as the ship tossed and turned, he and every soul upon that ship knew that storm was sent from hell itself to destroy us and our happiness. The day before had been a most wondrous day, with good winds, smooth seas. Soon we saw a smaller ship tossing and turning every which way. The crew did not seem as skillful as my own crew. In a matter of minutes, she was lost. We saved as many as we could, but divers souls perished that day. I personally helped to rescue one young lady who clung to our boat as we saved her and a few other lucky souls. She kept moaning, "Sebastian," in a most piteous tone, over and over. I had to drag her from the ocean to the beach because she was in a sad state. Her body was limp, and we had to carry her to safety. When she came to the next morning, she inquired as to what country we were in. When I told her Illyria, she did not seem relieved. She could only talk of Elysium. She was saddened that she believed her brother to be there. I, having a daughter of my own, felt the need to give her a spark of hope. I let her know that I did see her brother, clinging for dear life to the mast of the ship as it tossed in the ocean. I likened this missing brother to Arion to give the girl a little hope. It was quite a miracle that she was saved. If one miracle is possible, then two could have been possible just as well. Being that the girl was without friend or family, she was afraid to present herself by her name in her new home. She begged me to create a ruse and present herself as a eunuch so that she might be safe until she could devise a plan. I went along with this plan and intended to keep watch over her from afar.